So this will be the outlook of this Ferrero Rocher chocolate. Okay, whereby I'm going to attach about 9 of them to form a hand bouquet. There'll be some flower to be added in, and I will use black and gold as a theme color for this hand bouquet. Glue is there already. So this is chocolate. Apply some pressure on it. Okay, and we use a piece of transparent wrapping paper and just wrap it. Make sure the wrapping is tight. Neat cellophane tape and put them into the position that you like. Normally I will apply 2 layers of cellophane tape just to make sure that everything is okay. This is the glue that I put on the ring of the holder. So I do this repeatedly so that you are able to look at it for a few more times, so that you are familiar with how to do it. It's not very difficult, it's a simple process. So now I'm going to put a plastic wrapper on top of it. Make sure the top is free of wrinkles. Make it as transparent as possible, that look like it is an original packing. So on the neck of the chocolate, the bar, I'm going to put a layer of it. Sometimes I put 2 to make sure it is positioned properly. Okay, and I'll make 2 more just to demonstrate to you how to do the chocolate hand bouquet. So this is another stand that you can get from any flower accessory shops, okay, or balloon shops. They will have a lot of it. So I'm going to put 1 layer of glue at the brim of the stand here. Okay, so as you can see, the glue is on it, and I'm going to use another brown chocolate and then put it on top. Apply pressure for a little while, yeah, so that the glue is properly glued to the bottom packaging of the chocolate. The next step is we use the plastic wrapper and wrap this properly. Okay, cellophane tape, fit at the neck of the stick. Apply 2 layers so that they are more secure. So now I have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, you can see, as you can see that they are firm. Whichever way you swing them, they still stay in their own position. This is a close-up view of how I'm going to wrap this Ferrero Rocher chocolates using a transparent wrapping paper like this. It doesn't have to be very big, okay? Just maybe 4 inches by 4 inches will be good enough. So what I do is I do this, and over here you just use your these 2 fingers, just brush it down. And make sure they are tightened. Okay. And now I will apply a cellophane tape. To secure it. The sticks here can go through. Okay, so now when we open, it's gonna look like this. So we put this in. So it's going to look like this after the wrapping. And I'm going to apply the cellophane tape to it to secure its position. Now in the process you do have to adjust a little bit. Sometimes it may fall off. As we open this a little bit, then the Ferrero Rocher is there. So there's a nice contrast between gold and black color. Okay? So I'm going to demonstrate to you to do it one more time. Chocolate. Tissue paper. Okay. You can actually do this. At the center, you just do this, and there's a tip here. Just cut a little bit off the tip because we need to insert the sticks into it. Okay, so you can see that there's a little hole here. So what we do is we will just insert the stick into the wrapper. Hold it tight at the neck. Just a little bit. Then we're gonna use a cellophane tape and secure it. Okay, I'm gonna do one more. So that you can remember it better. So this is another one. Black tissue paper. At the center of it, point your finger there and just use another hand to just wrap it up. At the tip here, I'm gonna cut a little bit so that the the bar can go into it. So as you can see, there's a hole. See, the bar is coming. Okay, and then we have to go up. We have three. Okay, and I'm gonna make a total of 9 of these chocolate sticks. Okay, now I have arranged 9 for Ferrero Rocher chocolate. I think it's not 9, it's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes, 9 Ferrero Rocher chocolate in a round form. So this is the yellow roses that I have today. Okay, I'm going to wrap it with the golden foil wrapper. Okay, what we do is use our finger, go to the center point of the wrapper and use your hand just to put them down. Okay, and at the tip of it, you just cut off a little bit to allow the stem of the flower to go through. This is how it's going to look like. Of course, we need to adjust it again. Okay, we do this. Just hold on to this part lightly, and then we use a cellophane tape to tape it. Please apply some strength as you tape the flower stem with the golden foil paper. Okay, I'm going to demonstrate one more time. Now when you look at the flowers, those part that is not nice, you can actually pick them up. Okay, so that the flower looks fresh and natural. Okay, this is good enough. And I'm going to use a golden foil. Place my finger at the center of the foil and then use our hand to just push it in. Then it will give you a tip. So the tip will serve as the hole for the stem of the flower to go through. So you don't cut it too much, then when it's too big, the hole, it becomes very loose. Okay, so we just cut a little bit. Okay, that will be good enough. And then I'm going to start inserting the flower into it. Okay, see, this is how it goes. So. Okay. This is another one. And I'm gonna make the third one. Oh, this one looks pretty good. Medium paper at the center. Okay, put your finger at the center and wrap it this way. Cut a little bit. Adjust the flower, adjust the wrapping paper a little bit, okay, and tip it up. Okay, this is the third one. Okay, I have made 8 of these yellow roses with golden wrappers. Okay, so now I'm going to attach the flower into the flower roche chocolate, which I've wrapped with the black tissue paper just now. Okay, I'm going to show you how to do it. This is the chocolate. You just have to go around it. Now that we have 4, I will use a celloing tape to tape around first before I add in others. Okay, it's important that you hold on to the intersection between all the sticks here. And just rub it like how I wrap the chocolate bouquet just now. You can see it is a round shape, but looks like there's one more missing. So I'm going to do another one to insert it. Yeah, sometimes it depends on the size of the flower. If the flower is big, you will need less of them. If the flower is small, you will need more of them. Okay? This is the cotton that I'm going to use to wrap the foot of the roses. Okay, so I will dip it into the water. This is how it looks like. Okay. This is the flowers, and we will just put the cotton right at the bottom of it. Just to make sure that the roses got enough moisture to survive. And then the cotton, wet cotton doesn't have to be very much because the stems are quite long. There are no short stems here. So we can just put a little bit of cotton to wet it, and that's good enough. Okay, so we have already wet it. Now the next step is to put in the plastic bag that is waterproof. So I'm using this type of plastic bag. Normally it's like a flyer that we send the items that we sell on online platform. Okay, this is the flyers. I find it is quite a suitable material to use. Okay, now this is the bottom. What you do is you just go around it. Okay, after that you use cellophane tape to secure this place and the bottom. Okay, see right here, you have to pull, make sure that it is tight. Okay, you can also put another one at the center, pull it, make sure it is tight, and the bottom. Okay, so now we are ready to wrap this hand bouquet using tissue paper. Okay, now I'm going to use 3 pieces of black tissue paper and 3 pieces of golden tissue paper. Not tissue paper, it's a golden plastic wrapper. Okay, I'm going to wrap around it and make a nice ribbon, and then job is considered done. Okay, we can use 2 pieces of the black tissue paper and cut them into half. We have 4 pieces of black in a rectangular shape. Now we're going to do the same thing on the golden tissue paper. We also have 4 pieces of rectangular golden wrapper. Okay. The first step, yeah. Do this. To here, and part of it come up. You see this? Step one, and step 2. And what you do here, at the bottom here, you're gonna have to fold it like this. 1, 2, 3. Is this like when we fold a fan, paper fan? So you'll need to adjust it so that you can see my stand in this position so that you can see properly. Okay? Over here, fold it and pull the top. One more time. This is the shape that we want to have when we put our when we wrap our flower bouquet. So now this is ready. Just a little bit at the bottom so that it's neater. Get it? I'm gonna use another black tissue paper and repeat the same process. Okay, come up to here, right here. Then after that, at this edge, just press your thumb in and then try to fold it. Use the top part to help you straighten the paper. Okay, so this is this way. Just a little bit to make sure that they're even. Okay. Now we're gonna put this tissue paper on. See that we have already wrapped it on this side, so now it's the front part, yeah? To adjust the footing. So it's a little higher, right here and over here. So we're gonna put this down. And we're gonna tape it one more time. looks like at the moment. Now I'm going to add golden wrapper over this black wrapper as well. So you just have to repeat the same process. Thank you.